Hey everyone, this is Doug Kenny from Relentless and Unstoppable. Today we have Colin with us and we welcome him to the show. Hey man, how you doing?
Very well, thanks Doug, and thanks for getting us on here and having a chat about the world today.
No problem. Give our followers a little bit of what you're known for.
As everyone knows, I'm Colin Woods. I set up the first organization for adaptive to be taken seriously in boxing, which caused a lot of controversy. But basically, yeah, proving points was something I very much did so and set up the first organization to take adaptive seriously in boxing.
Pretty cool. What made you get into boxing?
I'm ex semi-pro rugby player. I was born with cataracts, which, if you can understand, playing semi-pro rugby with that deficiency, which I was semi-blind, as to say, which basically, yeah, it sort of years later, unfortunately, the sport was what made me go with a rare disease called uveitis, and that sort of changed my life to understand that rugby is a big part of my life, but feeling pushed out is something that made me get off my backside to set up what I'm doing today.
Cool. That's great to hear. So what's rugby again?
Rugby is a bit like American football. It's got all the same style, the hitting, the contact, but rugby in this country as well as worldwide, we don't wear helmets or shoulder pads. We actually use just our normal human intervention to go and hit someone.
Oh man, pretty interesting. So how did you launch that boxing thing you did?
Basically, being a rugby coach and playing rugby, I designed a ball which was to help me to assist myself with my own disability, as well as another gentleman over here who I helped to become a blind coach for rugby league. Basically, what had happened was that I was being pushed out of my own sport because there was a lack of understanding. Especially when you're being coached by able-bodied coaching ethics. And to me as a coach, if someone comes to you and says there has to be a change, it's a very hard pill to swallow when people don't want to change, and it actually infects you mentally and pushes you out. So I actually looked at all sports, which I can actually say to you that that's what I did. And I went straight to boxing because it was the more easier form of motion, which rugby or American football, if you see, there's a lot of movement, where boxing, it's an art. There's a lot of small little movements which help me to actually build up a basis for blind rugby to be initiated.
Pretty cool. What's your stand you've taken for special needs people?
It's about inclusion of all, Doug. The hardest thing is to, we've had many talks and I've got a great product that I designed, which was for basic ABC. The problem is that we all have weaknesses. All humans do. It doesn't matter whether you've got a disability. The problem is most people can't dance. But the problem is, like I said to you before, is that sport, we are not given a choice to anybody to actually see what they can do in order to encourage them, to point them in the right direction and see great skills come off, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it does. So you're all about inclusion and, you know, breaking barriers. What barriers do you want to break?
Well, the barrier I want to show is that basically everybody can be included. And to give you an example, and I mean, if I say this to you, see, from blindness, I've had to look at a team of people to play rugby or American football or that, which is box. And the unfortunate thing is it actually opened my eyes, pardon the pun, to that, which is that if I'm going to look at that one disability, then like yourself, you're wearing glasses. There's people out there that have got a deficiency in their eyes, which unfortunately, then they also have CP or MS alongside that. Now, if I took that and that level and it showed you that we can actually include all, then you've got to, the minefield is set small, because the unfortunate thing is, from blindness or from wearing glasses, we've shown that that deficiency with the eyes actually infects MS, Down syndrome, CP. So in order to include all, you have to look at that. And that's what we've missed out, I think.
Yeah. What's that patent you've created that you said will revolutionize the world?
I've revolutionized a mat which was both for wheelchair and for stand-up. And believe you and me, it's basically, I will be releasing videos shortly, which, you know, will show it as it is. Sometimes people have to be there to see it in order to understand it. And it's very hard to explain that movement. But if I say this to you, and everybody can do this, if you actually lift your arm up to go and open up a curtain, then basically that same motion, if I asked you to slap someone across the face, it would be the same motion, as well as pushing someone aside or even hitting someone with a hook. Now, the problem is the same is with that, with the motion of the wheelchair, as well as with legs. But it always came down to human motion. And that's what I found the ease in order to include all. But with the mat, I can honestly say to you that I not only can see your weaknesses, but I can also give you a direction on what sport you can play, even help you to dance.
That is incredible. What's your favorite sport of all time?
Oh, crikey. I'd have to go with rugby, because it's always been a passion. But the problem is, speaking openly, we all have our own stories to tell. See, rugby to me was all about going up against bullies. If you can understand, I was bullied from a child, from an alcoholic father. I was abused left, right and center, and I lost my brother, my dad and my stepdad to suicide, which at 19, when my brother committed suicide, it was a bit of a pill to swallow. So, yeah, it's one of them, isn't it, Doug? It's everyone's got a life, but it's what you do best to either become good, bad or ugly from that what's infected you.
Yeah, my sincere condolences on all those suicides. You probably heard, but Andy and me on the RNU platform, we host mental health panels where we try to prevent suicide through inspiration. And we would definitely love to have you on one of those in the future if you're interested.
I'd be deeply appreciated. I think as a man, I'll speak openly on myself, and I think people should be aware. We have to speak open. And the one thing I learned is that we can't save all, but I'm having a good time of trying to save those. It's a very hard bitter pill when I've done it to save life, and it's what you do with the money that counts, and you can make a lot of people smile from that. But you're never going to help everyone, and that's what the bitter pill swallow is, it's going to infect us, but there's not many people there to hold you up. And it would be great that people like ourselves, even men, can speak openly. I mean, I've been through so much. We all have a story to tell, but sometimes we don't feel like our voices are being heard, if that makes sense, even in the disability sector.
Yeah, you would probably know what I'm talking about when I say this, but I'm on the autism spectrum, and one of my experiences of bullying as a kid was I was bullied by people not because of malice or because of anything they had against me, but it came down to being excluded from activities in school, whether at recess or even at activities that I had to be part of for my education, you know, and I remember it got to the point where it was affecting my academics, and it resulted in the principal kind of warning my class of severe consequences if they kept excluding me. So, you know, I know what that's like.
It brings anger, Doug. I mean, come on. It's how to control that. You either become that the aggressor or you become the submissive. Sometimes if you put it both together, then it helps, because don't forget that there's a time and a place for everyone to be horrible. And the unfortunate thing is that, I mean, I can relate. And just to give you an example, guys, is that basically I used to have to wear glasses because of being born with cataracts, not being able to see. I had to sit at the front of the class, and that made me look like I was teacher's pet or getting the bully's bully. But then being bullied by an alcoholic father, you can see that, to tell you the truth, I went to school hoping that someone would actually, and then this is me speaking openly, I went to school hoping that someone would kill me. I gave up because, you know, your family's meant to be there to support you. And if you haven't got that support, then you start being neglected all for the wrong reasons. You start actually, and that's what I took into rugby, don't forget. I went up against big people to say, come on, who can take me out? And that's what's got me understanding I've done it wrong. If I had guidance, then I wouldn't have made those certain mistakes, which has actually jeopardized a shorter life for myself and can actually infect a lot more harm because of that, which is CTE and concussion, if that makes sense. Nobody likes getting abused, especially when you get punched across the head. But stubbornness, I won't. I mean, the only man in my life that actually scared me was my old man. And believe you and me, there's nobody else on this planet that will ever take that place again. I won't let it. And I won't. That's what I think the stubbornness is, because I see a lot of people out there fighting the same grief. But if you actually look at people more, you'll see that they're going through so much mental health, and nobody asks what happens behind closed doors, do they?
Not a lot of people do. And if they do, sometimes they'll just turn a blind eye, unfortunately, and not even admit to it unless they have no choice, like in divorce court, you know?
No, definitely. I mean, everything comes out in the end, and the unfortunate thing is it shouldn't. And believe you and me, we're quick to jeopardize or to criticize or to label anything. But I mean, when something good in the world happens, look at how many people say, oh yeah, this, that, and everything else. But then what about the people that haven't got the money to sue people and to get that right of barriers or being abused? It all comes with litigation or money, and it's a dog-eat-dog world then, because then innocent people do take their life from it, especially when you're either setting up business or trying to fight, which we've been talking about, which is now discrimination of sports so that disabled people can become elite level.
Yeah, it's really inspiring the stand you've taken for others. So this is the last question I have for now, but what are your hopes for the year?
Break barriers. I'm hoping to have a game of blind rugby, both stand up and in the wheelchair, against Australia, which, you know, with Jason Whiter, which is in talks at the moment. We're also going to build up for an ice hockey blind squad as well. And we're going to show, this is where that I would like people to come out, because we're also going to do American football as well. And believe you and me, if I can catch a ball from one end of the field to the other blindfolded, then it might encourage people to actually see that they can do great things. So we're pushing boundaries, and it's free. It ain't, I've never asked for anything. I just want people to invest into their communities, lay on great shows around it, and bring people out from different countries to come and meet and be a part of each other's life, because that's what this world needs. We need a togetherness that's never been done before.
Yeah, that's really cool. We'll definitely bring you back on in a few weeks or more, somewhere over the next few months, and definitely on a mental health panel, because yeah, we'd like you to join our stand of mental health and suicide prevention.
I'd love to. Anything to save life and anything to help out another community, show that it doesn't matter where you live, we should be supporting each other. We're all human, and we're all striving for the same things, but let's encourage each other to show that we have faith, but also that we're not going to rob each other. There's a lot of selfishness, and it's all about self-orientation, and that's greed. And we've got to be greedy for our community.
Definitely. So where can people find you?
It's the World Adaptive Boxing Council, which basically you'll find us on the website, which is www.worldadaptiveboxingcouncil.com. I'll give you the details so you can place up onto as a link, Doug. But it's basically this. They can look for me on Colin S. Wood on Facebook. And if anybody's out there struggling or wants advice, which costs nothing, and they want to achieve something, come and have a chat.
Definitely. So everybody, let's thank Colin Wood for appearing on the show. We'll see him again in a few weeks' time or more, and we'll see you next week for the next episode of Relentless and Unstoppable.